Sixth one, very important in MCQs also they ask this. Sixth one. Two point charges are at distance of 0.1 meter apart. They repel each other by force of 18 Newton. If the sum of charges Q1 plus Q2 is 9 micro coulomb, that is 9 into 10 raised to minus 6 coulomb, sum of charges, then calculate their separate values. We want Q1, we want Q2. Let Q1 equals to x micro coulomb. So Q2 will be 9 minus x micro coulomb. So x into 10 raised to minus 6 coulomb. This is 9 minus x into 10 raised to minus 6 coulomb. Force equals to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught product of charges upon square of distance. So 18 equals to 9 into 10 raised to 9. Charges are x into 10 raised to minus 6 and 9 minus x into 10 raised to minus 6 upon distance is 10 raised to minus 1 raised to 2. So 18 equals to 9 x into 9 minus x into 10 raised to minus 3 upon 10 raised to minus 2. 9 into 2 is 18. So we'll get 2 equals to x into 9 minus x into 10 raised to minus 1. That will become 2 upon 10 raised to minus 1 is x into 9 minus x. So 20 equal to 9x minus x square. Is this clear? Okay, just copy till this. When Q1 is 5, Q2 is 4, or Q1 4, Q2 5. This Sunday test you are knowing? Hello? This Sunday test you are knowing? 1 to 20 numerical, from that I will give any 5. 1 to 20 numerical. That you can easily manage. That's why I kept only numerical.
So 1 to 20 from the interference worksheet?
No. Just now we are doing now that sums.
Charge.
Page number 40 to 43, yes.
Okay, sir.
Sum number 7. The distance between two negatively charged dust particles is 1 millimeter. Distance between two negatively charged dust particles is 1 millimeter. So R is 1 millimeter, 10 raised to minus 3 meter. they repel each other by force of 4 into 10 raised to minus 5 newton. If the charge on one particle is 4 times other, so if Q1 is 4 times Q2, then find the number of electrons charging them separately. Okay, the charge on one electron take as 5 by 3 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. We want charge for first, we want charge for second. Okay, you can take Q2 is 4 times Q1. Force formula is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 upon R square. So 4 into 10 raised to minus 5 is 9 into 10 raised to 9 Q1 Q2 is 4 times Q1 upon 10 raised to minus 3 square. 4, 4 cancel. So 10 raised to minus 5 is Q1 square into 9 into 10 raised to 9 upon 10 raised to minus 6. Therefore, Q1 square will be 10 raised to minus 12, minus 11 upon 9 into 10 raised to 9. So Q1 square will be 10 raised to minus 20 upon 9. So Q1 will be 10 raised to minus 10 upon 3. Therefore, N1 times E is 10 raised to minus 10 upon 3. N1 into 5 by 3 into 10 raised to minus 19 is 10 raised to minus 10 upon 3. Therefore, N1 will be 10 raised to minus 10 upon 5 into 10 raised to minus 19. This is 0.2 into 10 raised to 9. N1 equals to 2 into 10 raised to 8. Clear?
Yes, yes, sir.
Then N2 will be 4 times. Huh? So it will be 4 into 2 into 10 raised to 8. 8 into 10 raised to 8. Sorry.
N1 and N2 are the number of electrons, right?
Yeah, correct. N1 and N2 are number of electron which is giving the charges. One electron means charge will be 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19.
Charges 4 times, that means even number of electrons is 4 times, right?
Correct. No? See, one charge gone, we got charge 1. 2 electron gone, 2. 3 electron gone, 3. That way. So if I have to make charge 4 times, so now loss of number of electrons should be 4 times.
Yes, done.
8. Two point charges of plus 2 and 2 point charges. Plus 2 microcoulomb and plus 6 microcoulomb. So Q1 is plus 2 microcoulomb. Q2 plus 6 microcoulomb. They are repelling each other by force of 12 newton. If each is given additional charge of minus Q, then what will be new force? Additional charge means Q1 dash is plus 2 minus 4. That is minus 2 microcoulomb. And Q2 dash is 6 minus 4, which will be 2 microcoulomb. So what is new force F dash? F is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 upon R square. So F upon F dash will be product of first charge upon second charge. So F1 is 12 Newton, F dash we have to find. First charge 2 into 6, second charge minus 2, that is magnitude wise 2 into 2. 2 cancel, 2 into 3, F dash equals to 4 Newton. Attraction or repulsion? First they were both positive. Attraction. Repelling, huh? Now it is attraction. So 4 Newton but attractive force. Unsh is not present.
Yes.
Done. Eight.
Yes.
Nine. Two identical metal balls A and B are charged with plus 40 and minus 10 respectively. Two identical metal balls are having charge of plus 40 microcoulomb and minus 10 microcoulomb. The distance between them is 22 meter. What is magnitude and type of force acting between them? Okay. If they are touched with each other and separated by same distance, calculate new force between them. What will be the force if one ball is connected to the earth? So first force before they are touched together is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon Q1 Q2 upon R square. That is 9 into 10 raised to 9, 40 into 10 raised to minus 6, 10 into 10 raised to minus 6 upon 2 square. 9 into 4, 36, so 360 into 10 raised to minus 3 upon 4. That will become 90 into 10 raised to minus 3. So it becomes 9 into 10 raised to minus 2. That means 0 point minus 12 and one more 10 is there. So 1600, 900, 9 into 10 raised to minus 1, 0.9 Newton, but attraction, attractive force. If two balls are touched together and separated. If two balls are touched together and separated, then Q1 dash will be Q1 plus Q2 upon 2. Q1 dash equals to Q2 dash and it will be half of total charge. So it will be 40 plus of minus 10 upon 2, 30 upon 2, 15 microcoulomb. So 15 microcoulomb. There will be force of repulsion now. Force of repulsion, F will be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 dash Q2 dash upon same distance square. So 9 into 10 raised to 9. Q1 dash, Q2 dash are 15 into 15 into 10 raised to minus 12. And R is same 2 square. Just copy it in this now, hardly 2-3 lines. Is you follow? No, when two bodies are touched together, separated, then charge will be half of total charge.
So why did we find the force?
They want, huh? They're telling what will happen if they are touched together and separated by same distance.
Okay, okay.
The question, there are three parts. First, original. Then you are touching and separating, what is force. Then earth, then what is force.
Okay, sir.
Just call Noons. Is he not well?
Yes, So instead he will join a different group because he had a power plant.
He will join later, is it?
Yes, he said he will join at 8.
At 8, okay. Earlier we decided to keep at 8. Coming week, 7 to 8:30 is okay, or you want 8 o'clock?
So I would prefer 8.
8, chalo. Pura June tak fir 8 to 9:30.
Yes, sir.
Theek hai.
Sir.
Haan, see.
Sir, but we'll be having 3 lectures a week.
Haan, 3 lectures, Monday, Wednesday, Friday.
So, but then won't we lose out on 1.5 hours?
3 lectures we are having na, Monday, Wednesday, Friday. We have 3 lectures only every time.
So like it's generally 1.5 hours, right?
Haan, so 8 to 9:30 is 1.5 na beta.
Oh, sorry, I heard 8 to 9. Sorry,
no,
sir.
No,
sorry.
No. Okay, calculated till end. Okay, second part ka I will show the calculation. 9 into 225 into 10 raised to -3 upon 4. So this will become, we can cancel by 4. 4 into 5 20, remainder 2 24 25. So 4 into 6 24, remainder 125. So 9 into 5 45, 9 into 2 18 and 4 22, carry 2. So 9 into 6 54 and 2 56, carry 5. 9 into 5 45 and 5 50. After 2-digit decimal, into 10 raised to -3, so it will be 0.50625. This is the force. Or they have rounded up 0.61 newton. Now, third part, they are telling if it is earth, then what will be the force? If earth, then all the charge will travel to the earth. Positive charge will go from high potential to low potential. So when one ball is earthed, then its charge will travel to the earth. That means it will become chargeless. Travel to earth. If it is traveling to earth, then force will become zero. Force between them will become zero.
Yes, sir.
Can I clear this now?
Yes, sir.
Once I have recorded the lecture, I will send, huh?
Thank you, sir.
Sunday, you will have test from first numerical to 20. Out of that, I will give you any 5 or 6. So right now we are doing 10th one. On page number 42 and 43. Two similar and equally charged identical metal sphere repel each other by force of 2 into 10 raised to -5 newton. They are having same charge, they are saying. A third identical uncharged sphere C is touched with A. Suppose this is A, this is B. Both are having equal charge QQ. Third, uncharged sphere C is touched with A. C is touched with A. So total charge will be Q now. Correct?
question.
After separation, A and C will have equal charge. That is Q by 2, Q by 2. This part clear first?
Yes.
They are telling, and then it is placed at midpoint of A and B. Then what is net force on C? A, C, B. A is having charge Q by 2. C is having charge Q by 2. And B is having same charge Q. Because it is not touched with A or C. A, C is kept in between. What is net force on C? A will give force to C of which nature? Attraction or repulsion?
Repulsion.
Repulsion. So this way it will move away. Na? So force acting on C due to A is this way outward. And B will also repel this way. Force acting on C due to B. Correct?
Yes, sir.
So whichever is greater, our answer will be towards that. Because these two are now opposing. Correct?
Yes.
So first, if they were at distance R, force was this one, 2 into 10 raised to minus 5. Now it is kept at R by 2, R by 2, because C is in the middle. So if I call this force as F, this one, FCA will be how much? Can I say 1 upon 4 pi epsilon? Q by 2, Q by 2. What is distance between A and C? 1 upon R by 2 square. Got it? Hello?
Yes.
So this is nothing but 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught QQ square upon 4 into 1 upon R square by 4. So this will get cancelled. Followed, huh? And this is nothing but 1 upon 4 pi QQ upon R square. 2 into 10 raised to minus 5. Correct? See, this F is force between two charges separated by distance R. So it is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon QQ by R square, huh? That F.
Yes.
So I got F. CA is 2 into 10 raised to minus 5. Now FCB we will find. Just copy till this.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Completed?
Yes, sir.
So we got force CA as 2 into 10 raised to minus 5. Now let us see what will be CB. This all sums you are writing in a book?
Yes.
Yes.
A force between CB will be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon C charge Q by 2, B charge is Q separated by distance of R by 2 square. So 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q square by 2 into 4 will go up upon r square. So this is 2. Now 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q square upon r square is nothing but 2 into 10 raised to minus 5 into 2. So 4 into 10 raised to minus 5 newton. What will be net force? CB is more or CA is more? CB more. So net force will be difference and directed towards A. CB is directed towards A. So net force therefore net force on C equals to CB minus CA. CB is 4 into 10 raised to minus 5 minus 2 into 10 raised to minus 5. So 2 into 10 raised to minus 5 newton towards A. This is the final answer.
Yes.
Next one we'll do now. Two conducting spheres A and B of same size are situated at some distance apart. Each has charge of plus coulomb and they repel each other with force of 10 raised to minus 5 newton. Two identical sphere, same charge q, separated by distance r, as force of 10 raised to minus 5 newton. First case. A third conducting uncharged sphere of same size is first touched with A. C is touched with A. And then touch with A and then with B and then placed exactly between A and B. Placed exactly between A and B. So this distance will be half of total distance. R by 2, C is placed. Placed exactly between this much, calculate resultant force on C. Similar to this, but only this time, the C is first touched to A and then with B and then placed between B and A and B, exactly in between. What will be charge on C, can you tell in this case?
Q by 2.
And charge on A?
Q by 2.
But when the C is touched with B, this time C is having charge Q by 2. And B is having Q, correct?
Yes, sir.
So when I separate, what will be the charge on Q on C? Will it be half of 3 by 2 Q? This total charge will become 3 Q by 2, na?
Yes, sir.
So half of this will become what? 3 Q by 4, correct?
Yes.
And this will also have 3 Q by 4?
Yes, sir.
So in final condition, A is having Q by 2, C is having 3Q, B is having 3Q by 4, C is having 3Q by 4. Clear?
Yes, sir.
This F is actually 1 upon 4 pi epsilon QQ upon R square. So wherever I say this, I will write 10 raised to minus 5. Now force acting on C due to A will be repulsive, this side. Force acting on C due to B will be repulsive on the left side. So force acting on C due to A is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, charge A q by 2, charge C 3 q by 4, distance is same, r by 2 the whole square. 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught 3 q square upon 8 into 1 upon r square by 4, 4 into 2 is 8. 1 upon 4 pi q by r square is 5, 10 raised to minus 5 into 3 by 2 newton. So 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 5 newton is FCA. Clear? FCA clear?
Yes, sir.
Come. Done, no?
Yes.
So this concept of touching and separating wala, I think it's clear now. 12. In the adjoining figure are shown three particles A, B, C, which are equally charged. Three particle A, B, C, which are equally charged. First distance 0.015 meter.
This is 0.010 meter. A, B, C. Then it is kept downward 0.10 and here 0.015 meter. A, B, C. The force acting on B due to A. Force acting on B due to A is 2 × 10⁻⁶ newton. Find out force on B by C. First one, then net force on B. See, there are two parts. We want to find force on B by C and then net force on B. Hello?
Yes.
In two cases, we want force exerted by B on B by C in two cases. On B by C. And force between B and A is given. So this given means actually what they have given. Charges are same. So it is nothing but 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q Q 0.15 and 0.10. Any relation between these two?
What does that mean?
If this is, suppose I take R1, this is R2, any relation between R1 and R2? R1?
2R1 is equal to 3R2.
That means you will take 0.015 upon 0.010, 15 upon 10, which is equals to 3 by 2, correct? Huh? So R1 is 3 by 2 R2, okay? Hello. So this is like R1 square. First case is 2 × 10⁻⁶. This is given to us. Now force acting on B. Force exerted on B by C. On B by C. On B by C. Will be repulsive this way. That will be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught QQ upon distance R2 square, which will be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon Q square. R2 is 3 by 2, R1 the whole square. So it will be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon Q square 9 by 4 R1 square. Okay. And 1 upon 4 pi Q square upon R1 square is 2 × 10⁻⁶ upon 9 by 4. So it will become 8/9 × 10⁻⁶ newton towards A. I hope you followed this. Towards A. Followed, na? Just copy this much. Force acting on B due to C is 8/8/9 × 10⁻⁶. Take a minute. R2 is 2/3. 2/3 R1. So 4/9. So it will become 4/9. 18/4. 4 × 4 = 16. Remainder 2. 4.5 × 10⁻⁶ newton towards A. Next case, force acting on CDU to B. Distance is kept same, so magnitude will come same. Only direction will vary. In second case, force acting on B due to C is same. That means 4.5 into 10 raised to minus 6, but vertically upward. This way it will repel. But vertically upwards. In second case, BC 2. This is, you can write FBC 1. Complete full, then I'm clearing this to explain you net force. Now this is B, first force acting is FBC1, second force is FBC2. So net force will be, by parallelogram law, this will be the net force, FB. Are these two forces perpendicular? Are the two forces perpendicular? And equal also?
Yes.
So when two vectors are equal and perpendicular, what is the result? Root 2 times any one force. Huh? Root of f square plus f square will become plus 2ff cos 90 will become 0. So will it become root 2 times f? So root 2 times any one force, either first or second. So root 2 times 4.5 into 10 raised to minus 6. Root 2 is 1.414 into 4.5 into 10 raised to minus 6. When you multiply, what it will become? How much it will become?
Approximately 6.3.
14 into 4, 56, na? 56. Net force acting on this. Both values we got same, 4.5 into 10 raised to minus 6. Net force on
B down.
No, no, one mistake I did. Even A will apply the force, and then we want resultant. One second. We got force acting on B due to C. Then we want net force on B in the two cases. First one. A, B, C. 0.015 meter and 0.01 meter. FBC we got towards A in first case. A is also having same charge. So this will give force on B due to A in opposite direction, repulsive. Force acting on B due to A will be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon qq upon distance r1 square.
So,
Force acting on B directly they have given. No need to calculate. I can say.
So we need to do 4.5 into 10x.
Just subtract, because both the forces we got now. Force acting on V by A is they have already given. So your net force on B equals to B is giving force on B due to A is 2, and due to C on B we got 4.5, na?
Yes.
C minus FBA will get. So this is 4.5 into 10 raised to minus 6, 2 into 10 raised to minus 6, that will be 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 6 Newton towards A. Then B part, this is force acting on B due to A, and this is force acting on B due to C. Therefore, resultant force, net force on B is root of F1 square. That means F1 square, if you call this as F1, and this is F2, plus F2 square. F1 is 4.5 into 10 raised to minus 6 square. And F2 we got 4.5 into 10 raised to minus 6 square. Hello?
Yes.
FBA is 2 into 10 raised to minus 6. So 2 into 10 raised to minus 6 and 4.5 into 10 raised to minus 6. 2 square is 4 plus 4.5 square will be 20.25. root into 10 raised to minus 6. So 24.25 into 10 raised to minus 6. What is square root of 24.25? 5? It will definitely be slightly less than 5. Enough. So this is 4.925 into 10 raised to minus 6 Newton. And direction will be, suppose this is theta. First copy again, tell this.
This is the net force at B in case 2.
Net force on B in case 2, yes. A force exerted by, on B by A is same in both case. C was different direction. Magnitude wise, they were same. So one net is subtraction, other net is Pythagoras theorem.
So one force was at 180 degrees to A, and one was at 90 degrees. One force was
in a straight line, na? So directly visit towards A. Other is Pythagoras theorem of these two. Resultant is this.
It is minus cos 180. Okay.
Cos 180 is okay. Otherwise, direct also two vector in same direction add, opposite subtract, perpendicular. Pythagoras theorem. By parallelogram law only we are getting what you said, same. Now this is net resultant force on B, which we got 4.925 into 10 raised to minus 6. Its direction we have to conclude. Let net force on B makes angle theta with horizontal. So tan theta is opposite side, that is FBC upon adjacent side FBA. FBC is 4.5 into 10 raised to minus 6. This is 2 into 10 raised to minus 6. So 2.25. So theta is tan inverse of 2.2. Okay. Thirteenth. Two point charges, 1 microcoulomb and minus 0.25 microcoulomb, are placed at distance of 0.25 microcoulomb are placed at distance of 0.40 meter from each other. Find out at which point on the line joining two charge should the third charge be placed so that net force acting on that will be zero. Where should be the point where third charge should be placed so that net force is zero? See, we don't want magnitude of charge, only we want where it should be placed so that net is zero. Can it be placed in between the two charges? One is positive, other is negative. If it is in between, positive charge will repel this, negative charge will attract, na? So resultant cannot be zero, correct? That means it should be kept outside. Now outside means there are two chances, either left or right. Force is inversely proportional to distance and product of charge. Yes. Hello? Q1 is greater or Q2 is greater? Q1. So its distance must be smaller, na?
Yes.
So it will be always placed closer to the smaller charge. It should be always closer to the smaller charge, because this I want constant. Not followed? Yes, I'm repeating. First, you got the idea it should be on the outside?
Yes, sir.
And net force should be zero on that charge? That means magnitude of force acting on third due to first must be same as third due to second. So 1 upon 4 pi epsilon q third upon distance between r3 square must be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon distance between Q3, Q2 upon distance between R3 2 square. This will get cancelled. Q3 cancel. Okay. Hello.
Yes, sir.
So Q upon R square I should get constant. Na? That means Q is proportional to R square.
Yes, sir.
That means it is closer to smaller charge. Charge small, distance small. This logic clear?
Yes.
Now tell me who is smaller, 1 or minus 0.25, who is smaller? Mm-hmm. 0.25 is obviously smaller.
So somewhere on this point, answer will be zero. What is that somewhere we have to calculate? We got, it should be on the right hand side. By that concept of force becoming zero, Q upon R square should be constant. So the point will be on right hand side of Q2 such that this distance we are taking as R, such that distance of point from Q2 be X meter. Therefore, at P, magnitude of force acting on third due to first means some charge here, third must be same as force acting on third due to second. So 1 upon 4 pi epsilon Q3 Q1, distance between 3 and 1 is 0.40 plus X the whole square, and 1 upon 4 pi epsilon, distance between Q3 and Q2 is X square. 1 upon 4 pi epsilon cancel, Q3 cancel. Q1 is 1 micro, so 1 into 10 raised to minus 6, distance 0.4 plus X the whole square. And Q2 is 0.25 into 10 raised to minus 6 upon X square. 10 raised to minus 6 from both sides cancel. Now taking square root, 1 upon 0.4 plus X, 0.25 is 0.5 X. So I get X equals to 0.4 into 0.5 is 0.02 plus 0.5, or you can make it half more easy. This much you followed? Yes, this much you followed? Hello?
1 minute, sir.
No, first you understand. Have you followed this calculation afterwards?
I'm reading.
Read first. Wherever you have not followed the concept that you asked. Because values can change, but concept will not change. Very important why I took on the right hand side. Because in between, direction will be same. It will be addition. Then Q upon R square should be constant. That means Q is proportional to R square. Q smaller, distance from Q smaller. So it will be on the right hand side of Q.
So could you explain again why is it on the right hand side?
Okay, explaining. Just copy down so that I will clear and explain you now. Solution part, copy, that's it. Okay.
See,
if I want net force zero by result of two forces, so first of all they should be opposite. So this was positive charge. This positive will repel, negative this will attract. Okay, this much followed?
Yes.
Now, force acting on third due to first must be same as on third due to second. That means 1 upon 4 pi epsilon q3 q1 upon distance r1 I am taking. This is 1 upon 4 pi q3 q2 upon distance r2 square. This will get cancelled. That means these two are same. When something upon something is same as same, so I will say it is constant, na, this ratio. Like if you say P1 upon T1 is P2 upon T2, that means it is constant. Na?
Yes, sir.
So that means Q upon R square is constant. No? So can I say Q is proportional to R square?
Yes,
sir. So if magnitude of charge is larger, distance should be large. This is more, so it should be large. That means it should be away from this. And closer to this, not followed now.
The distance from what should be more?
Charge of larger magnitude. 1 microcoulomb is large. And 0.25 is small.
The distance from the larger magnitude of charge should be more.
Yes. Directly proportional means that only. Na?
Okay, okay.
Large charge, large distance. Small charge, small distance. This was very good sum, can be asked in BITS exam. 2 point charge, 9E and E are placed at distance 16 from each other. 2 point charges, 9E and E are placed at distance of 16 centimeter from each other. At what point between these charges should the third charge Q be placed so that it will remain in equilibrium? So suppose I say it is placed at P at distance R. So this will be 16 minus R for equilibrium. Equilibrium is net force zero, huh? Hello?
Yes.
Let charge Q3 be placed at R centimeter from 9E for equilibrium. That means force acting on third due to first will have magnitude same as that of third due to second. So 1 upon 4 pi epsilon Q3 Q1 upon distance R square. 1 upon 4 pi q3 q2 upon distance 16 minus r square. So q1 is 9e upon r square, q2 is e, distance is 16 minus r the whole square. Take square root, 3 upon r is 1 upon 16 minus r. So 48 minus 3r equals to r. 48 is 4r. 48 upon 4 is R. R equal to 12 centimeter. Followed?
Yes.
So today we'll stop here. But test you will have till sum number 20.
Q1 and Q2 are both negative, right?
No, no, both they have given positive here. 9E plus 9E they have given. Na? Plus 9E means it has lost 9 electron.
So could you please read out this question? I don't have my textbook with me.
Question is, two charges 9E and E are separated by 16 centimeter. Where should be the third charge be placed for equilibrium?
So E over here doesn't mean an electron, right?
Pardon?
E over here doesn't mean an electron, right?
Yes, that electron can be lost also, gained also. No? So they have given plus 9E means it is due to losing 9 electron.
Okay, okay.
Shall I clear?
Yes, sir.
So that's all for today. We'll meet now on Monday. Acha, Sunday we are having lecture.